Hi, I'm Pat Patterson at Backblaze, the astonishingly easy cloud storage solution. I'm going to show you how to use MSP360's backup software to backup your server data to Backblaze B2 cloud storage in just a few minutes. With Backblaze B2 and MSP360, you can automate your server backups to secure your backup data offsite. This video shows how to set up MSP360's CloudBerry backup to backup a standalone server. If you're interested in backing up multiple servers, please take a look at our other video on MSP360's managed backup service. Once you complete the steps in this video, you will have a true set it and forget it backup solution in place. Here's a quick overview of what we'll cover. We'll start on the Backblaze website for the first two steps. In step one, we'll create a Backblaze account and download the MSP360 CloudBerry backup client. Then, in step two, we'll create a Backblaze B2 application key. In step three, we'll install the MSP360 client and configure B2 as a storage account. Finally, we'll create a backup plan and perform our first backup. After watching this video, you'll be able to easily recreate all of this in your own environment. First, we need to create a Backblaze B2 account. B2 is the cloud storage destination where you'll store your data. B2 is $5 per terabyte per month with no hidden fees, no tiers, and no minimum retention policies. Here we are on the Backblaze website. You can find this link in the text description below the video that says Start Now. Do make sure you use the link in the description as it is specific to MSP360. We've also included a link to our integration guide, which includes screenshots if you'd prefer to follow along with the written version. In this page, you'll find some information about Backblaze B2 and MSP360. But let's go ahead and click Start Now. As I mentioned, this video covers backing up a standalone machine, so we need a single server. Provide your email address and a password. Now, before we click the button, don't worry. You won't get billed and there is no credit card required. Backblaze provides 10 gigabytes free for you to run a risk-free proof of concept. And then, when you're ready to activate your account, you can enter your billing details later. Click the red button to create your Backblaze account and download MSP360. We can see that the MSP360 CloudBerry backup client has been downloaded. I'll come back to that later. With that, we've completed step one. Now, in step two, I need to create an application key. Let's go ahead and log into Backblaze. My username has been pre-populated in the field, and I'll just enter my password. Because this is my first time logging in, I'm offered some help to get started. I'm going to just skip past this for the purpose of this video. I need to create an application key. This will identify the MSP360 CloudBerry backup client to Backblaze. In the left menu, I click on Application Key. I'll just skip past the help. And I'll add a new application key. I'll call the key MSP360 CloudBerry. Now this key needs access to all buckets as the backup client will be creating a bucket. I can leave the defaults on the rest of the dialog and proceed. Here's the application key and its ID. It's important to copy this and keep it somewhere safe. This key is only shown once. You can't retrieve it later, although you can delete it and create a new key if necessary. That done, I can run the installer for MSP360 CloudBerry backup. I'll go ahead and install the client in its default location. Okay, we can go ahead. You can use the home version free of charge, but I'm going to start a trial for the full commercial version. I don't have an authorization code, but that doesn't matter. I can just supply my email address. Here we are in the MSP 360 backup client. Now, I'm going to want to back up some files. But first, I'm going to have to create a storage account. There are two Backblaze storage providers. You can use either. I'm going to use the original Backblaze B2 provider. I just give the provider a name, and then I paste in the application key ID and the application key that I created earlier. MSP 360 allows me to enable object lock. This is a feature that makes backups immutable. They can't be erased or deleted, even in the face of a ransomware attack. I'm going to go ahead and enable that feature. Okay, we've created a storage account. Let's go ahead and create our backup plan. I want to try out MSP 360 with my free 10 gigabytes, so I'll just back up my home directory. I'll just accept the defaults on the advanced options and allow compression and consistency checking. Now I'll schedule my backups. I'll schedule an incremental backup every night at midnight with a full backup every month. Now I get to set the retention policy for my backups. I'm going to keep my incremental backups for a week. And then I need to enable grandfather, father, son, so that I get access to that object lock functionality. I'm going to keep my weekly backups for 2 weeks, my monthly backups for 4 months, and my yearly backups for 2 years. Enabling object lock means that those backups are locked for those periods, and it's impossible to delete them while the lock is in place. Even if a piece of ransomware was somehow able to obtain my application key, it would not be able to delete those backups. The only way to delete data while the object lock is in place is to close your Backblaze account. So with that, we can move on. I don't need any pre or post actions, and I don't want any notification emails. Okay, everything looks good. Let's run our first backup. The backup started. We'll come back in a minute or two. Okay, it looks like it was successfully completed. Back in Backblaze B2, we can see the bucket that MSP 360 created. And if we drill in, we can see its backup files. As is usually the case for a backup tool, we can't directly see the files that it's backed up. If we go back to the MSP 360 client, we can see that it backed up the files in my home directory. Now, let's see what happens if we select all those files and try and delete them. Well, it looks like it's not going to work, but let's just go ahead. Even though I own this Backblaze B2 account and I have full administrative privileges, I can't delete those backup files. And I can see that this initial full backup is locked for the next 2 years, exactly as I specified in the retention policy. Now you've seen how to back up your files and protect them from ransomware with MSP 360 CloudBerry Backup and Backblaze B2. Don't wait to be a victim of data disaster. If you're interested in backing up multiple servers with MSP 360's Managed Backup service, click on the video on the screen. Or click our channel to subscribe. Thanks for watching.